are going to take up the discussion on the fourth question. But some questions may take more time because I am explaining. After some time, there is no need for much of explanation. That you can see proof of the following response can be provided by the corporate debtor to the operational creditor in response to his notice. As a response to his notice, proof of existence of dispute, proof of repayment of the thing that we have discussed already. So we are now going to the next question. So now we are going to this question number 5. For initiating corporate insolvency resolution process, operational creditor should file an application before A, Commissioner of Income Tax. Is it before Commissioner of Income Tax, Registrar of Companies, Adjudicating Authority, Board of Directors? Very simple. Under this code, only one person is adjudicating authority. So, adjudicating authority is the National Compiler Tribunal, and that is the place. Benches will be there, Chennai bench will be there, Madurai, Bangalore, like that. The place at which the registered office of the corporate debtor is situated is the only place. And suppose if it is in Ahmedabad, then Gujarat, then Ahmedabad we should go. Like that. So, adjudicating authority is the correct answer. Now, let's go to the question number 6. At the time of making the application for corporate insolvency resolution, operational creditor should furnish. That is, operational creditor should furnish that I have already discussed. A, copy of the invoice demanding payment. Name of the proposed resolution professional, both the above, none of the above. Now, friends, if you see, operational creditor will have to first comply by sending in form 3 and 4. That is, copy of invoice, 1, demanding payment, another 1, 3 and 4 is over. And there is no need for submitting the name of the proposed resolution professional, but that is required for financial creditor when he moves under section 7, then form 1 and 2 should be filled. So that particular distinction is highlighted. So the answer is only A. Only A. Now let's go to the 6th question. Let's go to this question. A debtor, 7th question we are answering. A debtor undergoing dash shall not be entitled to make an application for initiating the corporate dissolution process. Suppose the operational creditor has filed a case against the debtor and the case is admitted. Financial creditor has filed a case and it is admitted. And here, if you see, a debtor undergoing dash shall not be entitled to make application for initiating insolvency resolution process. See the difference between corporate insolvency resolution and insolvency resolution are two different things. As you know, who can initiate and what is the structure of this code, if you see. Corporate debtor means, 1, a limited company, 2, a private limited company registered under the Companies Act, and 3, limited liability partnerships, LLPs. This will be one class to which they are called as corporate insolvency resolution process. The other classes are partners, ordinary partnership firms, individuals and other artificial judicial entities. These people will go to their adjudicating authority is NCLT corporate, whereas for the others it is a bankruptcy, that is DRT, debt recovery tribunal. Now, there are three processes are there. A fresh start process for poor people, very low debt, and insolvency resolution process that will go for corporate people, and bankruptcy process is called as the third part category, that is individuals and other association of persons, etc., partnership firms. So, when you are already having that insolvency process, though the names are different, the insolvency process is such, the first level is restructuring, that is maximum 270 days. If you are not able to get restructured within that time, then it will be liquidated, which means assets will be sold, liabilities will be settled. That is the code, structure of this code. So, when there is a process going on, how can the debtor, on him already there is a insolvency process is there. So, he cannot again, why this question is important is, when corporate debtor also can move, only to get that benefit under moratorium, as discussed earlier. So, therefore, the question, if you read, when you are already corporate debtor is is under insolvency proceedings initiated by corporate that is the operational creditor, financial creditor for a corporate debtor or individuals, and they are very poor people, which is under fresh start process. In other words, all the three are insolvency process names. Insolvency resolution process will be for corporates, and fresh start process for very poor, below the limit of 35, like that, thousands. And the bankruptcy process is for individuals and partnership firms carrying on a business, right? So the answer is all the above. All the above should be the answer. Now we are going to question number 8. A resolution professional proposed by the operational creditor at the time of making the application will act as A, interim resolution professional, B, final resolution professional, C, both the above, and D, none of the above. What is the law? Operational creditor is only form 3 and 4, whereas this person will be going under this is interim resolution professional. According to the structure of the code, if you take, once the resolution must be carried on by an independent person who is known as resolution professional, and there are two stages in this process. Stage 1, in the first process of reorganization, when the case is admitted, immediately the resolution professional should be there, because adjudicating authority will order for public notice. So, yeah, that fellow who is going to do that process is known as interim resolution professional. That is for 30 days. His duty, his appointment itself is for 30 days. During this 30 days, he has got certain rules, certain obligations. And the most important obligation is formation of committee of creditors. So, if suppose that 30 days is over, to be frank, his appointment gets elapsed. So, after that, the committee of creditors which is formed, they will conduct a meeting and they can decide to continue the interim resolution professional as a resolution professional. And that fellow will carry on the job for a period of, total period of 270 days. So the two stages status are envisaged in the code. One is 30 days. That is interim resolution professional, and the next period which falls within that 270 days. The entire process of resolution from the date of admission is 270 days, 180 days extended by 90 days. So 30 days is a part of that resolution process. So formation of committee of creditors will be the main objective that we are going to discuss a little later. So what do you understand? If a resolution professional proposed by the operational creditor, if at all, there is nothing mandatory for it, but if he proposes, he is certainly called as interim resolution professional, because he may carry out the work of that formation of committee of creditors. And once the committee of creditors are formed, because the decisions are taken by committee of creditors, which includes only financial creditors. Financial creditors 100 crores, 75% of the decision, majority should make the decisions, as we have seen. So, therefore, the first stage is interim professional. Then, either the interim professional can be continued as resolution professional, or he can be replaced and a new person can be appointed. So, the answer is only A, and others will not come into the picture. Now, question number 9. The time period within which adjudicating authority is to ascertain the validity of the default mentioned in the application for corporate resolution is 14 days from the receipt of application, within 18 days from the receipt of the application, within 30 days from the receipt of the application, within 140 days from the receipt of the application. See, the structure of the code again we have discussed, once again we will understand. The who can move the adjudicating authority? Operational creditor, financial creditor, and debt, corporate debtor, all the three. With regard to financial creditor as per section 7, with regard to operational creditor as per section 9, corporate debtor as per section 10. So the first two, FC and OC, will attack the CD, and in the third section 10, CD himself attacks. That is the structure of the code. And once the case is presented, there are two things. You will have to do all the things, procedure, and submit to the registrar. Then he will go through and then fix a date in which a number is given for you. Listed date will be there. After that date, within 14 days, the adjudicating authority must give his decision. I have discussed about 14 days, then any clarification is required 7 days, 14 plus 7, 21 days. Whether 14 days is mandatory or can it be relaxed? Yes, the Supreme Court said 14 days is not a strict rule, though the adjudicating authority must keep the point in mind that it is a time-bound resolution process. But 7 days that is given to the appellant is a mandatory process. And say the totally 21 days, normally the matter will get settled. It will get admitted. Admission from the date of listing is 14 days. That's all. No other thing will work. 14 days plus 7 days. In case there is intermittent thing is there.